So this is the third video for the maps lab, and in this video lecture we'll be solving this map in which we have something special that we had learned in earth science. Now see, we have this A bedding plane. Now obviously I hope that you must be aware of all the terminologies by now. So this is the A bedding plane, this is the B bedding plane, this is the C bedding plane. Okay, here the name C is written, C. But after that, if you see, then here we directly have F. So after C, ideally there had to be D and then E, bedding planes. But here we have F, G, H, I, J, K. Okay, so that D and E are missing. So we had learned this in earth science, if you recollect, that in such scenarios when the bedding planes suddenly go missing, then that leads to unconformity, right? So this is a map which is showing an unconformity at this point at the interface of C and F. Okay, so the contour lines, bedding planes, bedding junctions, and this is the unconformity. The thing that we need to note here is the scale is 1:2000 and the contour interval is 10 meters. Okay, let us start with the map and let us see what is the question given. So the question is that the given geological map shows two sets of sedimentary rocks A to C in northern part and F to K in southern part. The map scale is 1:2000. The contour interval CI is 10 meters. It is required to find the strike, true dip and cross section along line XY. So step one is we need to plot those points where the contour lines, they intersect the bedding junctions twice, and then we need to draw the strike lines through them. So let us start with this bedding junction AB and let us see which contour line intersected twice. So we can see that this 90 contour line is intersecting here twice, so we can directly we'll draw a strike line through it and we will name it directly there itself. So the name of this strike line will be AB90 because AB is the bedding junction and 90 is the contour height. Same way for that bedding junction AB, which other contour lines intersects twice? So this 100, you can see it is intersecting first here and then here. We can draw a strike line, we'll name it as AB100, that's it. So is there any other contour point which is intersecting AB junction? That we need to check. If no, then we can move to the next junction. The next junction is BC junction. So to the BC junction, we have this 80 contour line which is intersecting, and we can name it as, and obviously the strike line will be common only. Okay, you don't have to draw the strike line again because even if you draw, it will be overlapping with the previous one. So that is, the name would be BC80. Then any other point where on this BC, you can see that this 90 contour is intersecting the BC here, and then on the other side it will intersect it somewhere here outside the map where it is not shown. But we know that this BC, if we extend it like this and if this contour line is extended, it will intersect somewhere here, right? So that we can obviously draw. So this is one point and this is the other point which is outside the map. We have to draw a strike line and the name would be BC90. Okay, now you see again I am following the color coding, that is 90 contour I am showing by red, then 100 contour I am showing by blue, and this 80 I am showing by yellow or orange, whatever. Then moving to the next bedding junction, that is CF. So for this CF, this contour of 70 is there, okay, and it is intersecting here at this point again, and it is on the same strike line, so we'll name it as CF70 also. Then now this entire surface of unconformity, it is actually, we'll call it a CF junction only. The reason is that ideally this F should have been there throughout, but because of the unconformity and because of the erosion that has taken place between the huge time intervals, that D and E has completely gone, but F is still there, some part of F is still there. Okay, so we should always take the immediate bedding plane, that is after C, the immediate one is F, and hence the junction, this junction is purely dedicated to CF. So that is CF 80, and on the other side also you will see that this F and this 80 will meet somewhere, and that will form probably like this, you know, that will form one point there. Now we come to the southern part of this unconformity, and on the southern part we have these bedding planes FG, HI, JK. Now if I take this FG bedding junction, I have one contour line which is intersecting it, this 70, and it is intersecting here at this point. But on the other side we do not know where it is intersecting, and we don't even know what is the strike direction, right? So first we need to ascertain what is definitely a strike direction. See, what I mean by this is that when I had these two points, I can definitely draw a line through those two points, and by the property of my strike lines, what I know that my strike lines are parallel to each other. For a particular slope, my strike lines are parallel to each other and they are at equal distance. Okay, so if I draw these two strike lines, the other strike lines I can directly draw parallel, and I can directly draw it at a distance. For example, for this strike line, I need not know where is the other point, where is the other point intersecting. I can directly take a line parallel to this line, draw it from this point, and wherever it will intersect, there has to be a point there, right? But that is not happening for this intersection here, this contour 70 intersection with the FG junction. We do not know where is the second point, hence we do not know what is the strike line direction. That is the reason we will first have to find a strike line direction by knowing exactly two points which are intersecting with a bedding junction, and that we can find by this. Here you can see a GH bedding junction, and this 60 is intersecting it twice, so we can definitely draw one strike line through it. Okay, and now you see that this strike line, I have drawn it in red color, and also it has a direction different to the direction of the previous strike lines. So these blue color strike lines are the ones of the bedding planes which are to the north of the unconformity, and this red color strike lines, these are the ones which are there to the south of the unconformity. So this GH is there, and now if I want, I can draw a strike line parallel to this one from this point. Okay, but that we'll be drawing later. We'll see what it is. So on this GH, is there any other contour line which is intersecting? So yeah, there is this 70 which is there here and here. So we'll draw a line through it, and I'll name it as GH70. Then I don't think there is any other strike line which is there. Any other contour line which is intersecting that junction. Let us move to the next one, HI junction. HI junction, we have 60 contour line, so I can draw a strike line through that. And now you see that these strike lines are again, they are equidistant to each other and they are parallel to each other. This name I will give it as HI60. Then on this HI junction, any other contour line? Yes, this 70 is there, right? So the other side of the 70 I do not know, but now I know the direction of my strike line. I also know that at what distance they occur, so I can directly draw a parallel line through this. And also, if I just extend this bedding plane, if I extend that bedding plane and if I extend the 70, it will meet it here at this point. So that way also you can find the missing point, and this gives us HI70. Then moving to the next junction, that is IJ. On this IJ junction, we have this 50 contour line which is there. We can draw a strike line through it. Then on the same junction IJ, we have this 60 here. I can draw a line through it, name it as IJ60. Then this 70 is there for this IJ junction here at this point. And the other side I do not know, but I can definitely draw a strike line through it, and or I can also extend my junction and this 70 would come down, and you know it will meet somewhere like this, you know. So this is my IJ70. Moving to the next bedding junction, JK. So this 40 is there. We draw a strike line JK40, and this 50 contour lines. Again, I'll draw a strike line JK50. Now 60 is also there here. So I can take a parallel line and I can draw from that this point. That will be JK60. And again, coming to the first point here, as we had already discussed, that this 70 is intersecting this FG junction. So from this 70, I'll draw a line parallel to this line, and I'll name it as FG70. Okay. So I guess all our strike lines have been completed. Now we can move to the next step, which is direction of true dip. Generally, our step 2 used to be drawing of missing strike lines, but by now we understand how we can find a missing strike line. So I have just merged those two steps in the previous one itself. This is direction of true dip. So we need to check the direction in which the contours are decreasing in their values and draw the direction. Looking to the strike lines, you will understand that there are two dips. Okay, definitely there are two dips, because first of all, the spacing is also increasing between the strike lines, and the directions are also different. So this blue set of lines are having direction this way, this red set of lines are having direction this way. So obviously the dip direction is also going to change, and the value of the dip is also going to change. And we intend to find the true dip, and hence we'll be taking these arrows need to be perpendicular to your strike lines. So you have to carefully draw these arrows perpendicular to the strike line, because later on for the calculation of the true dip, you know that we have to measure this line and then we need to find the true dip, right? Same way here, you'll have to measure this distance. So the amount of the true dip and the direction of the strike line. So direction of the strike line can be found directly. It is nothing but the angle that your strike line makes with the north. So this is the angle. So you can either write it as a quadrantal bearing, or you can write it as a WCB, whole circle bearing. So for whole circle bearing, you'll have to measure this entire thing and you'll have to write it. Quadrantal, you will just have to measure this much, and you will have to write north, that angle, west for the first set of strike lines. For the second set of strike lines, you will have to take your roller scale and you will have to draw a line parallel to this line along the north. Okay, from this point you draw a line parallel to these strike lines and you measure the angle. Then that would be north, your angle, I'll say, let us say it is beta, and north beta east. And for the first set of strike lines, that would be north alpha west, right? So this way you can measure those angles. Now coming to the amount of the true dip. So to find the amount of the true dip, we need to find the horizontal distance between the strike lines. And we had discussed this formula earlier as well, how the formula comes, this particular formula, in the first map that we had seen. We had discussed how this formula is actually formed, right? So we need to know the contour interval, that is 10 meters. It is already given in the map. So the contour interval is 10 meter. I convert it into centimeters. The horizontal distance, that is, since I have two sets of strike lines, for both the sets I'll have to individually find the true dips. So the horizontal distance that you need to find is actually this distance. Okay, this is the distance for the this is the direction of the true dip that you had drawn, and by the scale you have to find this distance, and this is for the first set. For the second set you will have to find this distance. Okay, so that is how and the scale is 1 by 2000, so that is how you will have to find the dip theta 1 and theta 2. Okay, moving to the next, this is the important part of drawing the cross section. We need to superimpose a strip of paper aligning with the cross section line. We need to mark all the strike lines, all bedding junctions and all contour lines. So this is the strip of paper that I take and I align it with XY. This is my XY. Obviously due to some limitations of PowerPoint, I cannot align it exactly. But you will have to align it exactly with your XY. You can see there is some gap here. That is due to the limitation of the PowerPoint. Okay. Now, when we align it, first we need to mark your XY. So X and Y, you just mark it on the strip of paper. After that, you mark all the strike lines and whatever name they are carrying, you have to write all those names. AB 90, AB 100, BC 80. Here is one strike line, this one, then all the red colored strike lines as well. Okay, so after marking the strike lines, we need to mark all the bedding junctions. So this is the bedding junction AB, BC, CF, FG. Here we have GH, this is HI, JIJ, JK. Okay, then after this you will have to mark all the contour lines which are intersecting this strip of paper. So this is the first contour line 90, then we have this 80 here, then we have 70 and 40 we have here. Okay, I guess I missed some strike lines. They are particularly the 60 which is there, but the 60 and this it is exactly coinciding with this GH, right? You can definitely write it, you know, you can mark that strike line, sorry, contour line. So this would be 60. And there is also this 50 which is again coinciding with IJ. Hence it is okay even if you do not mark it, because still you will be getting the correct results. Because the reason is that this 60 and this GH60 that you will be plotting on the graph, both the points are coinciding. Hence it is not important to mark those contour lines. Now we need to plot the strike lines. So this is the strip of paper that I have placed along my x-axis. Along the y-axis you can you will have to take a scale of as I have always told that along the y-axis the scale should be equal to your contour interval, that is 10 meters. So this is the scale of 10 meters only. This is 10, 20, 30. Okay. Now, we have to mark all the strike lines. So first strike line. From the strike lines you will have to draw these perpendicular lines. And the first strike line that we will be marking is JK60. Along this line at 60 we mark it, then JK50 at this point, JK40 here, and I think that's about the JK part. So we can join this, we will get our bedding junction JK. Then we have IJ70, so this is the 70, IJ60, IJ50, that's it about the IJ. So we can draw a line, this is your bedding junction IJ. Then we have HI 70, HI-60, and that's it, right? I guess. So we draw this wedding junction HI. Then we have GH-70, GH-60. We draw our wedding junction GH. Then we have FG-70. Okay. Now FG-70, we do not have anything else, but we can definitely draw a line parallel, because you know that all of these lines are actually dipping in the same direction. That is the reason they are in red, right? Or they are dipping also with the same angle. Next, we'll draw this blue set of strike lines. So first we have this AB90 at this point, then AB100. We'll just join them. This is your bedding junction AB. BC80, BC90, we'll join them. We'll have our bedding junction BC. CF 70, this is CF70 here itself, and CF80, and then we join it, we'll get our CF bedding junction. Okay, the next is we need to plot the points of the bedding junction. So this is AB, BC, CF. This AB should go and it should rest on this line AB junction that we have drawn. So this is one point. Then BC should go and rest on the BC one. CF should rest on CF. FG on this FG one. GH here. Then HI on this HI junction. IJ here. JK. That's it, right? The next is the contour lines that we need to plot. So 90 we have, 90 will go and meet the 91 here. This is the 90. Then 80 will go and meet the 80. 70 will come here. 60, so if you remember, your 60 would be somewhere coinciding with this one. It was your 60. So 60, if you plot, it will come here on this point itself. That is the reason I was telling that it is not important if it is coinciding with your strike lines, or if it is coinciding with a bedding junction, then it is not absolutely important to draw that one, because that will definitely give you a proper elevation. So why we are actually drawing these points is because we need the exact elevation of the surface. That is the reason we are drawing these points. Then we have 50, which was I think coinciding with this one, and that is again you would have got this same point, right? And the last one is 40. So now the points that you have to join are these blue points and these yellow points. Only these points you have to join and you will get a surface. So this is the surface, and everything above that surface you have to erase. Okay, now this B and B, this will become one junction. A, B, C, like that you will have to mark all the bedding planes, the names of the bedding planes. And this is basically your cross section for the unconformity. So that's it for this lecture. Till then, take care. Thank you.